Hi everyone, this is Key. I'm right here with my friend, well, he's over there, George Bryant. You can see it right next to me. He is the broker owner of the Lanham office, Exit Community Realty. He's also the co-owner of the Annapolis Exit office and the satellite office. And the country's been going through a lot. You know, they're in Maryland, so they see what's happening on the ground. Before we talk shop, how are you? How's your family? How's everybody in your life?
Oh, man, I'm great, man. Excited, energetic. The family's wonderful, growing. Children growing up, getting grown. The little one is good, doing homeschooling. Man, I'm fabulous. The people around me, we're doing great, man. We appreciate you asking.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that. So let's talk shop. As you noticed, the number of transactions, there was a slight pullback on the number of transactions, about 4 or 5%. But home values have been going up because of low inventory. How is the business where you are? Give us a sense of our agents, the business, the Maryland area. What's going on?
Well, Key, is challenging. It's a different kind of market. It's kind of weird. The loan restrictions tightened up during COVID, and it seems like we still have a heavy amount of buyers and still have low inventory. It's to the point where on Sunday we were out looking for a client that had put in actually 8 or 9 offers at that time, and we had to wait in line to actually see the property. So it was a line as if we were in the grocery store and we literally were on the sidewalk waiting for entry into the property. When we were leaving, people were still driving up, getting in the line for that one property. So the market, it was weird. When COVID hit, my business personally and the agents, we started getting more phone calls. I don't know if it was the fact that people were at home and had time to think about what they wanted to do. But I do tell you that the phone started picking up. It was calling. The people were calling more. And I tell you, man, the agents, especially our newer agents, their businesses started to rise. You know, so it's a strange market. It's low inventory, but we're getting a lot of buyers coming in. And right, we just had an offer that went out that we went over, I believe, 30,000 in the list price with no closing help, and we still lost that offer.
Wow.
So what we think people do is we have people now waiving home inspections and things as such to win an offer. Now, do we advise that at Exit Community Realty? No, we don't. We actually don't want to be attached to that unless someone puts it in writing that they refuse a home inspection after we educate them of the process. But the market right now is good if you're an agent that wants to actually get business done. So at the same time, it's challenging because you now have to educate your buyers on the process. And what do I mean by that? Well, you know, just recently I was working with a buyer that, you know, we were giving advice to, and they were not really listening to our advice and they kept losing offers. So when things like happen like that, what I share with our agents around here is you have to be very direct. You have to be very stern and very informed and educate your buyers and your clients, because what happens, the more offers they lose, the more they look at you and say that you're not a good real estate agent. Well, don't be timid, but be actually aggressive in knowing your craft and being honest. I mean, open honesty to the point where, you know, people can't look at you, but they will look at the market. So that's what's going on in this area. It's a challenging market, but it's a great time to be a realtor in this business. So
in essence, you have to be gentle and firm. You're saying, listen, this is your process, but we can't dilly-dally. We have to get the pre-qual done. We have to get everything. Our ducks have to be in a row, and you got to step up because these properties are not going to sit. They come and go. So the market is, from a buyer point of view, there's a challenge because there isn't enough inventory, especially in a specific area of pricing. But listing agents are doing really, really well. And that means we have to push our agents to become more prospectors, not just waiting for buyers, also working with sellers. So given that you're a prospector, you've been in the business a while, what advice would you give an agent to do well in any market, specifically this one? What advice would you give them?
Well, you know, that's a good question. You know, you have, you mentioned prospecting. So you have, using nature, you have a lion who's a hunter, right? And you have an alligator that's a lurker. You cannot be a lurker in any form, any market of real estate. You can't wait for business to come to you. You have to hunt. You have to prospect. You have to brand yourself. You know, market yourself. Marketing is a direct approach, and branding is an indirect approach. But either way, you have to prospect on both levels. You know, I find it very necessary that agents don't quit. You know, I always tell this story about when I used to live in Florida. I planted a mango tree, and I would always look when I was younger. I was, you know, I was into botany and plants and things as such. And so I would go out and see that this mango tree did not break ground yet. So one day I went and took my little shovel and I went to dig up the seed and saw that it had sprouted underneath the dirt. And I learned a valuable lesson. I had to exercise patience. I had to be consistent with watering that area where I know I planted that mango seed. And I had to actually, you know, work at what I couldn't work for what I didn't see at that time, if it makes sense. So what I tell any agent or agents around the country, be consistent in what you do. Be, as you would always say, be purposeful. Do things not as if you're throwing enough up against the wall to see what's going to stick. Know what's going to stick. Believe in what you do. I would go beyond belief. I would say no. What you're doing, because belief is the absence of knowledge. We can believe a thing, but it doesn't make it real. So you actually have to know what you're doing, and you have to be consistent, and you have to have a strong amount of faith. Because as I explained about that seed, I couldn't see that seed growing, but it was growing. Just because you don't see the results, if you're a new agent or a seasoned agent of the thing you're doing, don't stop doing it. Keep doing it, because at the end of the day, it is growing. I was talking to one of the students that was in your class, because, you know, we make your class mandatory at our office for all new agents. I don't care if they come a seasoned agent that came here from being 3 years in the business. They have to take your class. OK, that's the bottom line. So we make, and I was talking to one of the agents this morning about doing an interview, and I was telling her, you know, all of that hard work you did, that, because she used to come to me and say, you know, I'm mailing out cards, I'm doing this, and nothing is working. And I kept telling her, don't stop doing it. So once she took your class, everything came together. And this is not a plug, this is truth. You know what I mean? Everything came together. So now what I said to her this morning, I said, hey, all of those steps that you took, all of those things that you were doing were seeds being planted, and you just couldn't see the sprouting of that or the budding of that branch. And now you see it, and you're on your way to being a top producing agent. So I would say to every agent that's listening, just be consistent. You cannot quit. Stay the course. It's hard. If I told my story, Key, it might bring tears to somebody's eyes, but it's hard, and you have to be consistent. Me being a broker owner, I'm new at this. It's a challenge, and it's an adjustment. But one thing I know is that what I went through as an agent, the consistency and the things and the challenges, it built what we call fortitude. It built a sense of resilience and wherewithal that I can go through any storm, and I'm going to be successful. I don't have any doubt. That's my purpose. That is what I do. That's who my personality, and that is my energy. So I would say to anybody, develop that. Listen to your motivation in the mornings, your Eric Thomases, your Tony Robbins, your Les Browns, your TD Jakes, your Miles Monroes, your Earl Nightingales, your Jim Rohns. It doesn't matter who you listen to, but get some type of inspiration in the morning so you can leave out of here and challenge your day and be successful and dominate your craft. So that's basically what I would share with the Exit Nation and any new agent that's in the business.
Well, for me, the theme that you're talking about is a very important theme, resilience. Resilience is keep putting a foot forward all the time and never relegate prospecting to a second thing. You always put it front and center. If you put prospecting front and center and you stay resilient, it always produces results. You've seen it. I've seen it with agents. I've seen it with people who are brand new. I've seen it with people who have been in the business a while. Resilience and prospecting go hand in hand. So any parting message for our Exit Nation? Any positive message you want to send our friend at the Exit Nation?
I'm going to say this, and I say it with strength. Exit Realty has the best system and the best formula that any other real estate company can provide. I say that with true conviction, and I say that the Exit spirit, I would say the Exit culture is amazing. It creates a sense of family, you know, and I just love the fact that how we are. I love the fact that I can pick up the phone and call another broker and learn from that broker because we are one big Exit family. As agents, I feel that we, if we're in the same city or different cities, we should travel to learn more about our Exit family, the different things. I travel to see Sonny and Ray down in Jacksonville, and I make that a consistent trip. And they share with me the information that I need to be a successful real estate broker and a successful businessman. So based on our nation, and I say our nation with truth, you know, with a lot of emphasis, because we can call each other and learn. We can talk to one another and learn. I look forward to going over to Boston and see Derek Beatrice soon. So we can do these things and learn. So I say you're with the best real estate company that's out right now. Don't let anyone sell you on the illusion of 100% because it's not real. It's absolutely not real unless it's a loss leader. So at the end of the day, you're with the best company. I say take advantage of that. Reach out. Don't be ashamed. Don't be embarrassed to ask for help. Crave for knowledge and actually come out and ask any person that you know you can contact, even myself, about how to grow your business.
Well, I got to tell you something, George. A lot of our exit brokers who I'm going to be sending this to are going to want to chat with you, and I know you want to talk to them. I know that awesome. You do that from your heart. I thank you for being with us. I love your spirit. I love that you're a go-getter, and send my love to all of your agents.
Hey, man, we appreciate you, Key, and we love you, man. Keep up the good work, and let's get this class filled. And I got some agents coming to you here directly. Thank you, man.
You got it. Take care, my friend.
All right, take care.